Time to play with some clay. Yesterday I found a bunch of my tools that I had not been able to find for, well, since I moved. I found them yesterday, so I knew I'd find them, just a matter of time. I'm going to give this robe a stronger texture than the rest of the piece because I want it to stand out, and I want to use this heavy-duty wire here with real thick and wide serrated edge on that edge. I'll be back after as soon as I get all my tools.
All right.
Okay. Back to adding clay. Now his leather coat has a lot of wrinkles in it. The picture is going to help me form the wrinkles. He had quite a thick piece of fur that wrapped around the top of the sleeve. He also had some fringe that hung down from the bottom part of the fur, so I'm gonna make those now. The way I made this fringe was by running clay through the pasta machine. And using the pasta cutter as the thing to make the fringe. Now the trouble with using the pasta machine is it tends to curl the clay because it's sticky. So you just gotta weed out the sticky parts and choose the parts that aren't all misshapen. Do the other collar. I made a serrated edge on this piece of wood. We'll see if we can't get some kind of fur texture going. This is like a beaver skin, so it wasn't big long haired fur, it was just short stubby hair. Looks pretty good. Kind of drag and jab at it. Yeah, I like that. It looks like the fur. I mean, it's not. I like big furry, but that's not what it was. That'll do it for today. I'm about worn out. I am going to do that fringe again, maybe tomorrow. Still got a lot of work on his face yet. Okay, see you tomorrow, guys. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.